Welcome to this tutorial on setting up a fallback service with Google Cloud Load Balancing. Today we'll explore how to create a backup system that activates when your main service experiences issues. This isn't just a simple error page, it's a sophisticated, production-grade fallback solution. We're going to start unconventionally by reviewing a setup that doesn't work so that you better understand under-the-hood routing systems and don't fall for a common trap. Let's visualize that setup. We have a Google Cloud Load Balancer in front with our primary service running on Compute Engine behind it. Compute Engine is Google's infrastructure as a service offering, allowing us to run any web application or service we need. For this demonstration, we'll focus on a regional setup in the US Central 1 region. However, the principles we'll cover apply to various configurations, including multi-regional and global setups. Imagine a scenario where our primary Compute Engine instance unexpectedly fails. Our goal is to have a backup service ready to take over, providing either a scaled-down version of our site or an advanced error page that's much more helpful than a standard 404 message. We'll use unmanaged instance groups and Apache Web Servers to illustrate the concept. The tendency is to try pure load balancer routing for this, but we'll show how this isn't quite sufficient and then build on the concepts to get our desired behavior. Let's begin by diving into Google Cloud. If you're new to Compute Engine, you'll need to enable it first. This will allow you to create virtual machines and load balancers. We'll start by creating two VM instances, one for our primary service and another for our fallback. For both, we'll use mostly default settings, but make sure to allow load balancer health checks. Once our VMs are up and running, we'll group them into unmanaged instance groups. These will serve as backend targets for our load balancer. We're using unmanaged groups to keep things simple, but in a production environment, you might want to consider managed instance groups with templates for more advanced features. Next, we need to set up Apache Web Servers on both VMs. We'll use the SSH in browser feature to connect to each instance and install Apache. On the primary instance, we'll create a simple index.html file with the text primary web service. For the fallback instance, we'll do something similar, but with fallback service as the content. Now, let's set up our load balancer. We'll create an HTTP load balancing service, which operates at layer 7 of the OSI model. We'll make it public-facing and regional for this example. When configuring the load balancer, we'll start by setting up the front end. For simplicity, we'll skip HTTPS setup for now, but in a real-world scenario, you'd want to enable it for security. We'll need to choose our network and create a proxy-only subnet. The suggested range should work fine for our purposes. While the proxy-only subnet is being created, let's focus on setting up our backend services. We'll need one for each of our instance groups. For the primary backend service, we'll use the instance group we created earlier, specifying port 80 for HTTP traffic. The balancing mode isn't crucial since we have only one instance, but it's good to be aware that you'd want to adjust this later if you add more instances later. The health check is a critical component of our setup. We'll create an HTTP health check that sends requests to the root path of our web server. We'll keep the default settings for timeouts, intervals, and thresholds. Next, we'll set up the fallback backend service similarly. We'll use the fallback instance group, again specifying port 80. We'll create another health check for this backend, mirroring the settings we used for the primary. Now comes an important part, the routing rules. We want to set up a single rule that routes all traffic to the primary backend by default. This ensures that under normal circumstances, all requests go to our main service. After reviewing our setup, we can create the load balancer. It will take a few minutes to fully provision and be ready for action. Once the load balancer is set up, we need to ensure HTTP traffic is allowed on both our instances. We can do this without restarting the VMs. At this point, if we access our load balancer's IP address, we should see the primary web service message. Now, let's simulate a failure in our primary service. We can do this by stopping the Apache service or removing the index.html file on the primary VM. When we do this and refresh our browser, we might expect the load balancer to detect the failure and route traffic to our fallback service. Instead, our primary backend is servicing all requests, and even if it fails, we'll continue to serve an error instead of properly failing over to our backup service. This point is critical. You cannot fail over across backends, only within them. We'll need to introduce an additional layer to handle the failover here. The default backend is only important from a routing specification standpoint and is unaffected by health check statuses. Specifically, we'll create a second regional load balancer and implement failover at the DNS level. This will give us more control and reliability in our failover process. We'll start by creating another regional load balancer, very similar to our first one. It will also be public-facing and use HTTP. The configuration will mirror our primary load balancer, but this time we'll use our fallback instance group as the backend. Once both load balancers are set up and functioning, we need to note down their IP addresses. We'll use these in our DNS configuration. Now, let's dive into the cloud DNS system. This is where the magic of our failover setup really happens. We'll create a new DNS zone for a domain you own. For this example, we'll use notomatic.io, but you should use your own domain. After creating the zone, you'll see a list of named servers. It's crucial that you update your domain registrar to point to these name servers. This step ensures that DNS queries for your domain will be answered by Google Cloud DNS. Next, we'll add a DNS entry with a routing policy. This is where we set up our failover capability. We want our domain, let's say demo.notomatic.io, to point to both of our load balancers, with one as the primary and one as the fallback. Here's how we'll configure it. We'll create an A record for our domain. For the routing policy, we'll choose failover. In the primary section, we'll enter the IP addresses of our main load balancer. In the backup section, we'll enter the IP addresses of our fallback load balancer. We could also set up a small percentage of production traffic, like 5%, to always go to the backup. Next, we need to set up a health check for our failover policy. This health check will monitor our primary load balancer. If it fails, DNS will start directing traffic to our backup. We'll configure it to check the root path of our website and consider it healthy if it receives a 200 OK response. After setting up health check, we need to choose which regions will perform these checks. It's a good idea to select multiple regions for more reliable monitoring. Once everything is configured, we can create our failover policy. At this point, our setup is complete and we should test it thoroughly. Under normal circumstances, visiting our domain should show the primary service. To test the failover, we can simulate a failure in our primary service like we did before by stopping Apache or removing index.html. After a short while, depending on our TTL and health check settings, we should see traffic automatically shift to our fallback service. It's important to note that there might be a brief period where some users still see errors due to DNS caching. This is normal and unavoidable with DNS-based failover, but it's usually very short-lived. This setup we've created is powerful and flexible. While we've used simple Apache web servers for our demonstration, in a real-world scenario, your primary and fallback services could be complex web applications, APIs, or any other type of web service. If you'd like to support the channel, get a free trial of our new design tool in the description and let us know what you think. We'll keep an eye on the comment section for any questions and want to thank you for watching. Please enjoy responsibly.